Seattle-based Atomo Coffee is the brainchild of two friends. One of them, a food scientist, says he started working on a new product after he grew frustrated with the inconsistent taste of coffee.
So I decided to look into it and see if I myself could create coffee from the atom up, so building molecularly coffee to be consistently great.
The two friends decided to figure out what coffee is made of and then recreated. At first, his friend Andy Kleitsch was skeptical.
When Jarrett told me about his idea to create coffee without the bean, I thought, what, is this even possible? Why would you do this? Or how would you do it? And so we actually went to his garage and started formulating a cup of coffee in his garage in the middle of winter in Seattle.
Taking coffee and mapping out all the compounds, looking at both the nose compounds, what the aroma is and what the liquid components are, and then through a process of what we call omission modeling, removing them until it no longer was coffee, and then adding them back until they were coffee.
Just go ahead and sample them.
At a tasting against other brews, Victoria Exton makes her pick.
I like the one with the orange dot. I think it tastes a little more full-bodied to me. It's smoother. Just slightly smoother.
So here's the big reveal. The cold brew that you picked as your favorite is actually Atomo.
It's pretty impressive that that's actually a beanless coffee.
But is imitation coffee actually coffee?
We are making coffee exactly as you would experience it from a bean. We're just not using the bean.
One of Atomo's unique selling points is its small impact on the environment. The head of the U.S. coffee trade body said last year that low coffee prices may be pressuring farmers to carve out land in rainforests. Coffee grows in areas including tropical ecosystems, as do rainforests, which play a key role in sucking planet-warming carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere. Mariama Diallo, VOA News, Washington.